How cats domesticated themselves. So before humans settled down, there were wild cats everywhere. Okay, maybe not everywhere. But there were five main groups. Europe, China, Central Asia, South Africa, and the Middle East. Anyways, humans hunted and gathered for a while until some of us came to the Fertile Crescent and learned farming. It was hard to grow crops elsewhere, but this land was especially good for agriculture. So we learned pretty quickly here. Anyways, now we suddenly had a ton of food, so we decided to just stay in one place. We actually had so much grains and crops that we started making special buildings just for storing food. We called them silos now, but they were probably called like Ooga Booga House back then. As all the food was centralized in one place, it made it easier to attack. Man, I really disagree with the current government's policies. I wish I could do something about it. Well, you could boycott, strike, or riot. Or I can take a dump in the Ooga Booga House. Human attacks were easier to defend from, but a worse threat were mice. When they started eating grains, humans tried to keep them out. They probably tried to chase them down, left a little food trap, or hired a hitman. Man, I really don't agree with the humans' morals, like they pet one animal and eat another. Like, look, all I eat is grains. See? Humans did have dogs, but they were more defensive than offensive. And since the mice weren't a direct threat to humans, they were left alone. Now, there was a genetic group of wild cats near each of the first civilizations, Mesopotamia, India, and China. But the Indian cats were across the Himalayas, and the Chinese mountain cats were too feral. Just like their people. This just left the Middle Eastern cats with Mesopotamia. Now, generally, wild cats like to go for smaller targets, like frogs, birds, Roombas, and of course, rodents. Eventually, wild cats showed up due to the abundance of food. No, not that food. This food. And it wasn't always in silos. There were mice that ate trash on the outskirts of the village, which made wild cats more likely to venture closer to humans. And it was perfect, because cats have a primarily meat diet, so they don't eat stuff like wheat and barley. Well, kind of. Over time, humans and wildcats became more comfortable around each other. Around this time, some people started taking baby wildcats into their house as pets and rodent catchers. Honey, open your present. Let's see what you got. Okay. But they became friendlier over time. But then why are they so similar to their original feline cousins? Like, dogs came from wolves, and look how different they look now. Well, that's because these early cats were set free and ended up mating with their wildcat cousins. This helped keep their feral side even after living with humans. Eventually, as each civilization traded with each other, the Middle Eastern cats spread everywhere. These other civilizations also accepted them as they kept the rodents out. Eventually, the Middle Eastern cats were friendly enough that there was no need for the other four types.
Hey, get out of here, boy. We don't need your kind around here.
But even today, house cats remain genetically very similar to wild cats. Seriously, the only difference is that they have a wider variety of coats, like unlucky black cats, weird gray cats, and dumb orange cats. They tolerate humans, but are not domesticated. But all this is from the human perspective. What about the cat's POV? Oh, well, they see less colors. But felines don't have a complex social structure. It's literally just like colony members and outsiders. There's no leaders or followers. They have territories, but they also have neutral grounds where they go to just chill. Like, sometimes mothers will share kittens and raise them together. As there was a lot of food in the human settlements, these areas became the neutral ground. And humans actually ended up eventually taking the responsibility of raising kittens. We also fed and took care of the cats, which made them have a more kitten-like relationship with us. Rubbing against our legs, meowing, making biscuits. These are all traditionally kitten behaviors. Like, they meow just at humans, not even at each other. And their social structure makes them harder to train as well. Like, wolves hunt, sleep, and chill in packs. But cats hunt alone, so they're less social. Hey, stop that! Bad cat! Bad cat! And being more independent, they ended up semi-domesticating themselves.